And a pleasant Wednesday, everybody, the 13th of May, 2020. Yes, it looks like we may have a little something that's going to try to develop, but before I even get going, there's going to be a low that marches down from Canada and across, and it may interact with this some, but this system that you're looking at, they put this out at 8 o'clock this morning Eastern time. It's just looking like it's going to be, when it starts out, just a broad area of low pressure. Now, it's expected to develop late this week or early this weekend near or within a couple of hundred miles north of the Bahamas, as you can plainly see. Now, this is all from the National Hurricane Center, and it's looking like environmental conditions appear conducive for some gradual development of the system, and a subtropical depression or storm, now this is subtropical, is likely to form this weekend while it moves northeastward over the western Atlantic. So, with that all said and done, I've been nosing around this morning looking at all kind of models for you folks. And let's go take a look at them, and I will tell you what it is looking like. Now, I've got many models I'm going to show you, okay? So just stick around, and we'll all make our decisions together here, but I'll give you my honest opinion, okay? This is the European model. We got this big high out over here. When I turn it on a little bit, you can see I've got this set for Saturday around 8 a.m., it's down here. Now, when we go over to the GFS model, it will change. It will change some. Now we have the GFS model. You can see it's bringing it up a little further, closer to the coast of Florida. It does have some good rain bands in it, but it's still not tightly compact as a tropical storm. I think this will be, it might, before it's over, have some good wind gust in it, maybe some sustained wind, but not that bad. But it's looking like a blend of the European model and the GFS model is what I've been using for the basis of this storm right now. And this is in 3 to 5 days. This is like Saturday through Monday I'm talking about. Now, it's looking like more weight is placed towards the GFS relative to the European model. The GFS forecast was closer looking to the overall ensemble consensuses, with the area of low pressure expected to develop off the southeast coast. That I'm telling you about, it's going to happen. Now, elsewhere, the solutions, they're comparable with relatively minor timing amplitude differences for the various features that I'm talking about. Now, the weight placed on the ECENS and GEFS ensembles, which I'm going to show you, those means was increased a little through time, with the majority forecasting weight on the ensemble means during Tuesday and Wednesday by the middle of next week. Now, the models differed to the evolution of the eastern seaboard, and any potential interaction between the area of low pressure that I told you is going to drift down and northward well off the southeast coast and the northern stream shortwave energy, in general guidance has trended toward a more amplified northern stream shortwave, but solutions still differ on that degree which the shortwave interacts with any possible subtropical low. Now, it's looking like the GFS is showing a much more extensive interaction, resulting in the development of a deep upper low off the eastern seaboard by the middle of next week. And it's showing more limited interaction, where the European model, which is continuing to go much slower than the overall consensus with the moving of the southern low northward, is showing no interaction at all. So here we are on the GFS. We'll click this. You can see the timestamp here. Here it is right here. Before we go any further, let's just check the wind in it at this time. This is sustained winds here. Not too bad at all. 36 miles per hour. And that's going to bring a little bit of a maybe beach erosion. But more than likely, you can bet there's going to be some rip currents going on. So anyone out, you need to pay attention. Highest wind gusts at this time are looking like 37 miles per hour. Well, now, 37 miles per hour is considered a tropical storm. But I don't think it's going to do a whole lot of damage right now, folks. If you look at the rain, most of the rain is staying offshore. So we will click it up to around 6 p.m. Saturday, and it's starting to move on out, as you can see, by 11 a.m., 12 p.m. Sunday. This is not tightly compacted at all. Doesn't look like any kind of tropical storm. Looks like a big old maybe subtropical depression. We will check the wind in it at this time. Not too bad of sustained winds. This is looking like the highest. It's way out in the ocean at 32. That's just a low pressure. We'll go with the wind gust. Now, it does have some good wind gust in it whirling around here, looking like some of the highest of those will be 42 miles per hour. This is the wind gust. Now, what I was talking about in my forecast earlier this morning, you can see this goes counterclockwise. So this is going to bring water in along the North Carolina coast. Now, I'm not saying we're going to flood out, okay? It's nothing more than what we're used to. It all depends on how long it stays this way as to how the flooding situation might get. So I've had time to go over it now. We'll go up to 8 p.m. Sunday evening, and this, of course, is the GFS model. The water is still coming in, so it's looking like probably Saturday and Sunday, we're going to get some water to start getting higher around these areas and little creeks and rivers and things of that sort. We'll wait, see what happens, but this is what it's looking like to me. Then by Monday, looks like it's moving on off. We will go to Tuesday. Here's the low that was up here. Let's go back a second. I want to point something out to you right quick. Here's this low I told you that's going to be coming down. Here's a system off the coast here. We'll move up to Tuesday. And you can see it interacts with that low, and there it is. By Wednesday, it splits. We got a high pressure pushing on it. Pushing on it. We have one low up here. They're both the very same in barometric pressure. At 29.64, doesn't look like a big deal. Rain is no more than what is normal at this time. Of course, all of this can change. We do have a little bit of wind that's coming down, as you can see right in these areas and up around Maryland. You guys are going to have beach erosion. You got some steady, sustained winds around 28 miles per hour, and the wind gust should be, let's see, that's going to come all the way to the Outer Banks along Virginia Beach up into Maryland and some of southern New Jersey. You guys, these are 43 mile per hour wind gusts at this time. Now, we see what's going on. Let's check the European model for the same time. It'll switch over in just a moment here. Here we go. Ba-boom. You see the difference. You see the difference in what's going on here. It's still just an elongated low pressure, maybe subtropical. I don't think it's going to be really that bad bringing rain. We'll have to wait and see what happens as this low pushes, or as this high, I should say, pushes this low on out. We'll go to Thursday over here. It's still here. It's not tightly compacted. Just looks like a big old low pressure system. We've had some much, much worse. Now, let's go check out something else. Now we're looking at the ECENS model. And you can see, as this low develops, and moves along all the different barometric pressures that are with inside of this particular low system. And it doesn't seem to hit any land, looking like it's staying off into the ocean, starting down here around the Bahamas. As it's moving up, it does intensify some, as you can see, as it begins to pull up and move on out. This is the ECENS model that I was talking about. It's been put ahead a little bit of time to kind of weigh out to see what might happen. Still looking like it's just going to go off the coast everywhere. Now, as we take a look at the GEFS plots for the spaghetti plots as they move along, you can see a timestamp right here. We'll just click it up, let you see what's going on. This is what the weather is as of right now, of course. This is Friday. Now we're getting into Saturday. Not a whole lot going on coming up from the Bahamas, as you can see, so far as severe tropical weather. Not a whole lot at all. So I just wanted to point this out as they put these two together and weighed them out. This is what it's looking like. This thing shouldn't get but so severe, and it should move on off the coast. Now, as we take a look at the GFS model, remember I told you that it's like it's showing more limited interaction? Well, check it out. Here we go. Now you're going to see, here we come up, here it is. Looking like the pressure's still fairly high in it. 1,003 millibars. Gets down to 997 right about on Wednesday, middle of next week. Here's the other low I was talking about. As it comes down, you can see what happens. There's not that much interaction with it at all. It moves on out and across and over. So hopefully, folks, there's not going to be a whole lot to this. There's going to be beach erosion probably along the Florida coastline on the beaches here. Rip currents from Florida, maybe Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, Virginia, and also up in Maryland. All the different models are showing a little bit of different things going on. But I wouldn't expect a great big storm as of yet. However, all of this can change within the blink of an eye. You know how crazy our weather is. So, you know, it's not too early. You should have already done it to have your supply kit ready for hurricane season. We never know when one might pop up and one might materialize and strengthen to a greater degree. And this still might, I just don't think it will as of now, and I think we'll all be okay, no more than what we're used to, if we receive anything from it. By tomorrow, I may be singing a different song, but right now, this is what it looks like to me. If it does develop into a tropical storm, it will be named Arthur. But right now it's looking more like a subtropical depression or a subtropical storm to me, not a full-blown big tropical storm. If it does get to that degree, it shouldn't last very long at all. And it looks like no interaction with land at this time period, just the beating of the waves coming in with some wind gust up there and some beach erosion. And that's a check of your tropical weather. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate it. You have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day, and peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. Thank you for watching.